My wife wanted me to ask, if Jim was alive today, do you think that he would embrace the social media, see it as something of an art form, or just a big annoyance?
I think he would love it, you know. I think he would make use of it, and, you know, he wasn't a guy who would shun the future or anything, any, yeah, just you know.
The opposite. Just the opposite, man. He was always looking ahead. But ultimately, Jim and John and Robbie and I have to make the music. I don't care how it's distributed. I don't care how it gets out there. I don't care if you listen on little tiny earbuds but that don't have any bass that go boom, 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 boom. I don't care if it sounds like that. It's my job to make the music. It's his job to write those songs. We make the music. That's what we do.
I think it was great that we were on Elektra Records because it kind of gave the aura of us, the Doors, being an underground band. And I think the Doors is still an underground band. I think that's how people think of it. You know, people think, hey, I discovered the Doors. Have you heard those guys? You know?
Amen.
We're never like the Beatles or the Stones, you know? Smart people like the Doors.
Amen.
And that's a compliment to all you guys here. Thank you so much for having brains in those heads of yours. You know what I miss, man? I miss playing with John and Jim when we had that unit, that thing that would just be like a hammer. I mean, we'd hit a groove that just was relentless and powerful, and it would be totally transcendent. You lose yourself in the power of that musical moment, and it's like it's a Zen meditation.
Yeah, I think that once in a lifetime you have a group of guys that fit together like that, and it just works, you know. And, you know, I've tried last 40 years to get that together again. It just, you know, it's very, very, it's very tough to do. You know,
I met these guys in the Maharishi's meditation too. What's interesting is that Jim and I went to UCLA, and then after a series of bummer LSD experiences, but the good side was that I went to heaven. And the other side is you go to hell. So if you're interested in finding out what existence is all about, I highly recommend LSD as opposed to alcohol, speed, and cigarettes and your little typey-typey books and whatnot. But meeting Robbie at the meditation and John at the meditation meant that they were both spiritual seekers looking for something more. There is something more than this mundane three-dimensional existence we live in. And it's something that's known to mystics and philosophers and people from all time and around the world. You are one with all existence. You are God, if I dare say it. Whatever your religion is, you are the Messiah. You are God. And these other guys, man, John and Robbie, were their seekers the same way that I was, looking for that spiritual trip.
And you have to experience it. That's, you know, that's why we took acid, to try to experience that. But, you know, really, and I think that's why Jim may have died so early, is because he wanted to experience it too soon.
The Negroes of the Forest. That scene that he paints is so primal.
The Negroes in the forest, brightly feathered, and they are saying, forget the night, live with us in forests of azure. Out here in the perimeter, there are no stars. Out here, we is stoned, immaculate.
Man, that is one of the greatest lines ever written. Because when you are stoned, and you are out there on the perimeter, you are immaculate. This is psychedelics we're talking about. This is expanding one's consciousness. This was a journey to become immaculate.